Hello, believers, family, and friends, and welcome to this very special edition of Crazy Faith TV. Today, we celebrate 150 years of God's goodness to the Allen Chapel AME Church of High Springs, Florida. Please join us, you, your family, wherever you are, join us this morning in saying our church mission, vision, and theme statement. We are Allen Chapel, the house of crazy faith. In this place, we worship, study, and believe God's word. We endeavor to create an atmosphere of healing, deliverance, and breakthroughs in every aspect of our lives. Our mission is to be a safe haven of peace for our community. In this place, no dream is too big. Our praise is authentic. We walk in our purpose, and God always hears and answers our prayers. We are the house of crazy faith, and we believe God. At this time, we have a very special greeting from our own mayor, the Honorable Reverend Byron Williams, the mayor of the city of High Springs and the pastor of the Mount Carmel United Methodist Church, who is going to bring us official greetings on behalf of the great city of High Springs.
Greetings in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I am the mayor of the city of High Springs, Byron Williams, who come to bring you greetings on your 150th anniversary, a church that I'm very, very aware of, a church that my family was raised in, the Johnsons and the Williams. I have much history in this church. For the last 150 years. I wasn't here 150, but my people was here. I remember my grandmother, my aunt, selling cakes and pies to make their dues. Even up to the day that they transitioned, I still had to make sure I bring their dues to the church. Although they were sick, but they had a love for Allen Chapel, the same love that I have for it. I spent many of Christmas, Mother Days, and Easters, and funerals here at Allen Chapel. So again, Allen Chapel truly is a part of my family, a part of me. And I just want to say, God bless y'all for celebrating 150 years. That's a milestone. That's a milestone. If my history is between Allen Chapel and Mount Olive, who is the oldest churches in, I understand it, Allen Chapel is the oldest church here in High Springs. A church that's, again, that's very, very dear to my heart. So again, I just want to say congratulations on 150 years. And again, we're going to say, greetings from the city of High Springs. Allen Chapel, y'all made history. Y'all made history. Again, God bless y'all, and may God continue to keep you and protect you.
Now, please join us in our scripture reading. This morning, our very own Commissioner Gloria James and trustee of Allen Chapel will be reading our scripture this morning. Let's get ready to dig into God's word.
Good morning, everyone. Our scripture lesson for today will come from 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 8 through 13. Verses 8 reads, "Charity never faith, but whether there be prophecy, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part, and we prophesize in part. But when that which is perfect is come, then that which is in part shall be done away with. When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then shall I know even as I also know." And the last one is verse 13, which reads, "And now abideth faith, hope, charity. These three, but the greatest of these is charity."
special news bulletin calling all of our family and friends. If you are in Hot Springs, Gainesville, or anywhere near Alachua County, on Saturday, August the 29th, we will be having a special car wash and barbecue sale here at Allen Chapel. To all of our members who we haven't seen in the last couple of months, we would love for you to come out and fellowship with us. Please pre-order your barbecue from Brother Jeremiah Young or reach out to me directly. We want you to be able to pre-order your barbecue dinners or your barbecue sandwiches and be able to come and get your car washed on Saturday, August 29th. We want to see your face. At this time, Sister Pat Dixon is gonna come to us and give us some special birthday shout outs and recognize some wonderful folks who've been celebrating birthdays all summer long.
Good morning. Isn't it a beautiful day in the neighborhood? Let us rejoice and give God the glory for it all. And let us be glad in it. We owe some birthday shout outs. On July 4th, Mrs. Brown had celebrated her birthday. July 21st, Sister Avon Miles celebrated her birthday. And on July 28th, Brother Jeremiah Young Jr. celebrated his birthday. Our August birthdays include August 2nd, Brother John Durr. August 3rd, our very own Pastor John Ingraham. August 7th, Brother Abe Andrews. August 21st, our own J.R. Young Sr. August 17th, Sister L.B. Rashad. And a special anniversary celebration for our own Pastor Ingraham and Lady LaJoy celebrated their 4th anniversary. Give them some glory and some shout out. It's celebration time, everyone. Allen Chapel AME Church is celebrating our 150th church anniversary. Woo-hoo-hoo! We've been here for 150 years, and we're just thanking God for letting us come this far by faith. We honor him and give him the glory, and the best is yet to come. So sit back, relax, and welcome again to our 150th church anniversary.
As we celebrate 150 years of God's faithfulness to this body of believers, we want to say thank you, each and every one of you, for what you continue to do to be a blessing to this ministry. Today, all of the officers and members of this great church will take part in a very special seed offering as we strategically and intentionally sow a special gift into this ministry to celebrate these 150 years. And so if you're watching this worship experience this morning, I'm asking you from the bottom of our hearts, please join us and sowing a seed this morning. You can do so online through the Givelify link that's at the bottom of the screen. We would love for you to partner with us as we continue to do great things in the city of Hot Springs for the kingdom of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You can also send that offering directly in the mail to us at Allen Chapel P.O. Box 1335, Hot Springs, Florida 32655. We appreciate you, we love you, and we are grateful for what God is getting ready to do. It's time for the word. The Reverend Dr. Marvin Zanders is one of the best preachers anywhere. And my family and friends, we are getting ready to really get fed from God today. Dr. Zanders has pastored the St. Paul AME Church in Jacksonville, Florida for 20 years, and he has done an outstanding job serving as a part of the leadership team in the Episcopal District here in the state of Florida and the Bahama Islands. He is a candidate, the only candidate that Florida is endorsing for bishop, and he will be running for that office next year at the General Conference that has been rescheduled for 2021. He is a mentor of mine. I've known him all my life, and my family and friends, I guarantee you, you will be blessed by today's sermon. 150 years, our preacher today is Dr. Marvin Zanders future bishop of the AME Church, current pastor of St. Paul AME Church, Jacksonville, Florida. Let's get ready for the word.
Praise the Lord. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. I bless and praise God for this wonderful day that the Lord has given us. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us all be glad and rejoice in it. Certainly we give honor and praise to our God, in whom we live, move, and have our very being. We honor and thank God for the wonderful leadership of the Senior Bishop of the African Methodist Episcopal Church, Bishop Adam Jefferson Richardson Jr., and his wonderful wife, our beloved supervisor, Dr. Connie Spates Richardson, for their leadership and for their work for kingdom building. We honor and praise God for the presiding elder of the Alachua Central District, presiding elder Elizabeth Elaine Yates. And we thank God for the man of God, the angel of this house, Brother John Ingraham, and the wonderful work he's doing alongside his partner in ministry, Sister LaJoyce Ingraham. And we rejoice for them as God is blessing them to be able to lead the wonderful congregation called Allen Chapel AME Church, High Springs, Florida. Certainly to all of the officers and members and the community and all of our virtual friends, how good and pleasant it is for us to be here in God's presence. We honor God and we thank God for Pastor Ingraham extending us the invitation and the courtesy to be the preacher for this 150th, this sesquicentennial year of this wonderful Church of God, the St. Paul AME Church, Jacksonville, Florida. Last September, we celebrated our 150th, our sesquicentennial year, and we're excited about the marvelous things that God is doing. The best is still yet to come in Christ Jesus. Thank you again, Pastor John, for the opportunity to be here, and we pray God's continued favor upon you and this ministry. Call your attention to the Gospel of Mark, chapter 2, beginning at verse 1. Mark chapter 2, beginning at verse 1. A few days later, when Jesus again entered Capernaum, the people heard that he had come home. So many gathered that there was no room left, not even outside the door. And he preached the word to them. Some men came, bringing to him a paralytic carried by four of them. Since they could not get him to Jesus because of the crowd, they made an opening in the roof above Jesus, and after digging through it, lowered the mat the paralyzed man was lying on. Verse 5, when Jesus saw their faith, he said to the paralytic, "Son, your sins are forgiven." On this sesquicentennial celebration, I want to talk from the subject of faith that shows. A faith that shows. The church is, the church has been, and the church will forever be the greatest institution of all time. When I allow my mind to go down the corridors of yesteryear and look across the balconies of what has been, I can see the many tears the church has wiped, the many fears the church has calmed, the many confused minds the church has regulated. Oh, I can see the many broken hearts the church has mended, and I can see the many joys the church has celebrated. That lets me know that the church has been, the church is, and the church will forever be the greatest institution of all times. You do understand the church has its challenges, the church has its opposition, the church has its blunders and faults. And so many people will say, well, I don't want to be a part of that because there's nothing but a bunch of hypocrites down there. And I take the position tonight that I'd rather be in church with some of the hypocrites than to be in hell with all the hypocrites. And so here it is, 150 years, the Allen Chapel AME Church High Spring is still standing through many dangers, toils, and snares. It's a legacy of love that's continuing. And as Captain Tennille used to sing and still sing, love will keep us together. And so here it is in the midst of all of the racial tension and violence and upheaval, going on in our world in the midst of this global health pandemic called COVID-19. The Church of the Living God is needed more now than ever. And I know you say, Pastor, how can you say the church is needed when the building is closed and we can't get back there and we are not been there in days gone by? Because the church is not a building. The church is derived from the Greek word ecclesia, which means called out ones. So the church is a living organism. In other words, you and I are the church of the living God. In other words, the church is not a place we go to, but the church is who we are. When we are saved and sanctified, we become the church of the living God. You do remember when the Lord asked at the coast of Caesarea Philippi, his disciples, he said, "Who do men say that I am?" And they went through a litany of names. But Peter shouted, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." And Jesus himself said to Peter, "Upon this rock I build my church, and the gates of hell should not prevail against it." What he was saying is, Peter, upon your faith, upon your profession, I'm building the church. And here in Mark's gospel, right here at chapter 2, as Jesus has been moving around, and he now comes again to Capernaum, and the people heard that he had come home. In other words, our heart is the Lord's home, and the Lord ought to have permanent residence in our lives. And somebody ought to hear that the Lord is living within us, and the Lord is leading and guiding us. But they were also speaking about that particular place, the Lord's house. And the Bible says in verse 2, so many. It didn't say many. It said so many gathered there that there was no room left, not even outside the door. I want to tell you, sisters and brothers, wherever the living Lord is, crowds will come. You do remember, it says, and crowds followed him, and the multitudes went with him, because people want to be wherever Jesus is. And they said Jesus was there, and he preached the word. Yeah, I come by to tell you, we have to preach the word of God in season and out of season. We have to preach a word of hope. We have to preach a word of encouragement. We have to preach a word of critical evaluation and analysis, so that we will all examine ourselves. And this anniversary gives us the opportunity to reflect and to look back on where God has brought us, and where we are now in God, and where it is we want to go in God. And so it says he preached the word to them. In other words, he wasn't preaching CNN, and he wasn't preaching a whole lot of medical and science, but he was preaching the word. How many of you know that the word of God gives you life? The word of God will give you strength. And that's why the word of God says, "Oh, taste and see that the Lord is good." And he preached the word of God to them. And in verse 3, this is where we get excited. It says, some men came. In other words, we thank God that men are a part of the church. Women are part of the church. Children are part of the church. But this text says, some men came, and they were bringing to him a paralytic. In other words, I don't know what had paralyzed the man. I don't know whether it was a relationship. I don't know whether it was some inhumane actions toward him. I don't know why the man was paralyzed, but the text says that he was paralyzed. And it says that these men came bringing to him. Didn't say they were taking him to church. See, because sometimes we think that all people need is the church. No, people need Jesus first, and then they need church in us who are the church, in order that they can find their wholeness, that they can find their identity, that they will not be looked down upon, but rather they can know that they have special presence and a special place in the sight of God. Look at the text. It says, some men came, bringing to him a paralytic carried by four of them. First thing we discover, if we're going to have a faith that shows, if the world is going to be able to see our faith, first of all, we have to be concerned. In other words, we just can't be concerned about me and mine. We got to be concerned about the whole world. You remember Nehemiah, who had gone to the place of the cupbearer in the king's court, but he was concerned about what was going on back at the hood. And I just want to remind you, if our faith is going to show, we must be concerned. See, people don't care how much we know until they know how much we care. And these men undoubtedly had a relationship with Jesus and had come to a place where Jesus had worked out some things in their lives, and they realized that this man, their friend, he couldn't get to Jesus, but they were going to bring him to Jesus. Let me tell you, sometimes we can't get them on the mat, but can I tell you, we can take them to the Lord in prayer. Can I tell you, we can pray to them, pray to God about them, their situations and their circumstances. But the Bible says that these men, these four men, carried this paralytic to Jesus. Oh, I like that, because not only must we be concerned, but you also see some unity. See, you can't spell community without having unity. And the Bible tells us a house divided against itself cannot stand. So as you've lived and existed for 150 years, you must understand we have to be a place of caring. And because we care, we share. And these men wanted their friend to know about Jesus. But look at verse 4. Since they could not get him to Jesus because of the crowd. Don't you know the crowd is always getting in the way? The crowd that says, we'll never done it this way before. The crowd that says this can never happen. The crowd who doesn't believe that the power of God is able to renew, revive, heal, and forgive. You know, the crowd, and so many people in the crowd stops people from getting to Jesus. You know, we're not looking for a crowd. We want a congregation, and we want people in the core who will be concerned about what's going on and be willing to be unified. And so it says they could not get him to Jesus. I want you to again focus in on the fact that they were not talking about getting him to the church. And so many of us during this pandemic, we are messed up and mixed up because we can't get to the building and get to our favorite seat or get to the favorite place. But let me tell you something. When you are the church, wherever you are, you can worship. Wherever you are, you can pray. Wherever you are, you can praise. And these men were not concerned about getting the man to the building, but they wanted to get the man to Jesus. And they could not because of the crowd. And look what it says. And they made an opening in the roof above Jesus. You see, everything is centering around Jesus. And see, what's the challenge and the problem in too many of our congregations? We are into so many other things, but we are not into Jesus. And the Bible says, if any person is in Christ, they are a new creation, and all things have passed away. So a church, a faith that shows, first of all, is a concerned faith. But secondly, a faith that shows is a creative faith. Yes, they became creative. It says they couldn't get the man to Jesus because of the crowd. They made an opening in the roof above Jesus. That's all I'm trying to tell you. When it looks like you can't get there, when folk are blocking you, you have to go a little higher. a little higher in your praise, a little higher in your fasting, a little higher in your giving, a little higher in your witnesses. They went higher, and they were creative enough. They said, we're going to go up. And the Bible says that when they went up, right above Jesus, it says, and after digging through it, I don't know who that's for. Somebody got to dig through some stuff. You got to dig through church hurt. You got to dig through feeling left out and looked over. You got to dig through people who won't recognize you for now who you are in Christ because they remember you when. I don't know what you have to dig through, but when you are creative and concerned and the purpose is to get the person to Jesus, you will not stop at any cost. And I come by to tell you, when you are creative, look what happened. It says they made an opening in the roof above Jesus, and after digging through it, the mat that the paralyzed man was lying on. And when Jesus saw their faith, when Jesus saw their faith, in other words, first of all, after 150 years, and as you're observing and celebrating this sesquicentennial year, we thank God that you're still a beacon of light and a citadel of hope and an oasis of love. Because number one, we're still concerned. Number two, because we're still being creative. Even in the midst of the pandemic, we're finding and discovering creative ways in which to get people to Jesus. We're not trying to get to the church, we're trying to get to Jesus. And the reason I want you to know that we need to get to Jesus, because when people criticize the church and they say that the church is not doing anything, they are not talking about the building that sits at the address that makes up Allen Chapel, AME Church, High Spring, but they are talking about the people whose names are on the roll. And so here it was, these four men, they brought their paralyzed friend to Jesus. And they did not allow the crowd to stop them. But the Bible says they went a little higher. And that's all I want to encourage you, Allen Temple. After 150 years, you ought to be ready and willing to go a little higher. And the Bible says when they went a little higher, they start digging through some stuff. And that's why I'm so glad the Bible says, no longer be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. And the Bible says they lowered the man right down in front of Jesus. And the last thing I want to tell you, you got to remain committed. In other words, when the storms of life are raging, and when it looks like you have more month than you got money, you still must be committed to getting people to Jesus. And the Bible says, when Jesus saw their faith, in other words, faith is trusting God enough to do what God tells you to do. And can I tell you, when God gives you a job, and when God gives you vision, God will give provision. Yes, can I get a witness? And the Bible says he saw their faith. And as I close here, I want you to know today that without faith, it's impossible to please God. Because those who come to God must believe that God exists, and that God is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. And so it is, Pastor Ingraham and the great members of Allen Chapel, High Springs, I want you to know the Lord is not finished with you yet. I want you to know your faith is still showing. And when your faith shows, it's a concerned faith. And that's why it's not only a concerned faith, but it is a creative faith. And then it is a committed faith. Yes, and the Bible says that some people were having a little argument within themselves. And the Bible says that Jesus knew in his spirit what they were thinking and talking about. Can I tell you, you better be careful, because Jesus is the unseen guest at every dinner table. Jesus is the guest in every conversation. And Jesus went on down here in verse 11. He said to the man, I tell you, get up, take your mat, and go home. Yes, ain't the Lord all right? When you are committed to doing what the Lord tells you to do, you will see miracles in the midst of a mess. You will see possibilities in the middle of problems. You will be able to experience midday in midnight. And the Bible says the man got up, took up his mat, and walked out in full view of them all. And that's all I want to tell you on your sesquicentennial anniversary. When you see the things that the Lord has done, you ought to be willing to give God a praise. Can I get a witness? And the Bible says this amazed everyone, and they praised God, saying, we've never seen anything like this. And I come by to tell you, when you remain concerned, creative, and committed, the Lord will do exceedingly, abundantly, above all more than you can ever think, ask, or imagine. Can I get somebody? It started with the faith of those four friends. And that faith spawned Jesus to take action toward the man. And when the man heard the word of Jesus telling him to get up, take up your mat, and go home, I come by to tell you today, just take him at his word. And in closing, let me say here today, without faith, one cannot please God. Without faith, one cannot receive salvation. Without faith, one cannot survive adversity. And without faith, one cannot overcome temptation. And without faith, one cannot obtain the victory. And I just come by to tell you, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord will deliver you up out of them all. I just come by to tell you on this sesquicentennial celebration, faith will receive what God gives. Faith will believe what God says. Faith will trust what God does. Faith will obey what God commands. Faith will go where God sends. Faith will abide where God chooses. Faith will answer when God calls. And faith will listen when God speaks. Ain't God all right? Because faith can see a light at the end of a tunnel. Faith can see a rainbow in the midst of a storm cloud. Faith can see the sunrise coming, although the night be dark. And all I want to tell you, be not dismayed, whatever be tied, God will, he'll take care of you. Yes, he will. A faith that shows, first of all, is a concerned faith. Number two, a faith that shows is a creative faith. And finally, a faith that shows is a committed faith. Happy sesquicentennial anniversary, Allen Chapel, High Spring. Let your light shine that people will see your good works and give glory to God the Father. Amen and bless God.
What a word, what a word, what a word. And what an opportunity for you to respond to this word. As we move forward in faith, let us do so in pure obedience to the Spirit of God. If you are looking for a church home, it does not matter how far you are, it does not matter where you are in your life, we would love to become your family. So, are you a believer? Are you looking to make a decision to become a part of the body of Christ? We would love to grow with you. Text BELIEVER to 786-707-0369. We would love to be your family. Let's grow together. This week, we're praying that God walks before you to guide your path. May the Lord walk behind you just to watch your back. May the Lord walk beside you so you never know what it feels like to be lonely. And finally, may the Lord walk all the way around you just to keep you covered. Thank you for worshiping with us today. May the Lord bless you real good. Have a good week.
Go on.